Hai, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Asfariza bin Muhammad Masmur from Bachelor of Applied Science Fisheries. Today I'm going to present my final year project in the title of A Review on the Health Risk Assessment of Heavy Metals in Malaysian Blood Cockle Tegelaka Granosa. My supervisor is Dr. Rizawati Abdullah from Faculty of Fisheries and Food Science, University of Malaysia Terengganu. Tegelaka Granosa is one of most important production bivalve species in Peninsular Malaysia and known as good income for the local community. It contributed around 4.25% of total national aquaculture production in 2018 with a value of 1.34 million ringgit Malaysia. As a filter feeder organism, blood cockle tend to accumulate pollutants, especially heavy metals from environment. Therefore, heavy metals abundance in coastal areas, particularly near estuaries, will expose a harmful effect to the human health through consumption of contaminated cockles with toxic metals such as cadmium and lead. However, there is a lack of data on risk assessment and the potential harmful effects on consumption of blood cockles from various locations that found in Malaysian coastal areas. For the significance of this study, the risk assessment of cockle consumption from Malaysian waters is critical to ensure that they are safe to be eaten by consumers. On the other hand, metal elements level in blood cockles tissue is important to formulate a plan in controlling the source of contaminant and manage the production from contaminated blood cockle areas. The objective of this study is to review the concentration level of heavy metals in blood cockles from different coastal areas in Malaysia and their potential health risk to the consumer. Three steps of methodology has been applied during this study, which is first by search of related published articles through online electronic database such as Google Scholar, PubMed, ResearchGate, ScienceDirect, and Springerling, using various keywords such as Tegelaka granosa, blood cockle, heavy metals, metal toxicity, metals accumulation, standard food regulation, and many more. Next step is all screen data and information of related articles were chosen. The data from chosen articles were extracted and organized particularly based on sampling locations and concentration of each trace elements, author's name, as well as year of publication. From the reviewed articles, it has been observed that the concentration of heavy metals in Tegelaka granosa from various coastal areas in Malaysia will range from 0.02 to 12.2, 0.04 to 20.75, 0.113 to 15.4, 0.23 to 15.78, 3.12 to 158, and 3.0 to 875.55 microgram per gram for cadmium, lead, chromium, copper, zinc, and iron respectively. The review was revealed that 17 out of total 26 areas of cadmium level were higher than 10 microgram per gram as set by Malaysian Food Regulation 1985 safe limit. This non-essential metal in cockle was found highest in Selangor, particularly from Kuala Selangor. It is believed that source of this contaminant may come from anthropogenic waste that flows from industrial and urban areas along the Kuala Selangor River upstream. Consumption of cockles from this area will expose the harmful effect of cadmium-related disease such as iritated disease, vomiting, diarrhea, kidney and skeletal damage, and many more. For lead element, it was observed that 7 out of 20 areas were exceeded safe limit concentration by Malaysian Food Regulation 1985, which is set at 2 microgram per gram. This type of toxic metal was found highest in cockle from Kuala Seputang, Perak. The accumulation of this metal was high in this area, maybe caused from waste of largest charcoal factories in Larut Matang and extinct mining around this area, as well as fisheries vessel emission. Therefore, possibility health risk effect on consumption of cockles from this area was such as brain and kidney damage, Minamata disease, renal dysfunction, birth defect, and many more. The copper element from previous study shows that 3 out of 27 total samples concentration has reached safe limit at 10 microgram per gram as set by FAO-WHO. The highest concentration of this element was observed from Kuala Selangor areas and may caused by waste of copper-based industry as well as excessive pesticide used in agriculture and plantation regularly along the Kuala Selangor main river. Consumption of cockles from this area will lead to various types of copper toxicity such as kidney and liver damage, gastrointestinal tract problem, anemia, and many copper-related disease. Zinc concentration from 6 out of 25 areas was reached safe limit at 100 microgram per gram as set by Malaysian Food Regulation 1985. The highest zinc from Kuala Selangor probably came from waste of herbicide and pesticide residues from plantation and agriculture activities, and this will probably affect the level of pollutant, especially along the Kuala Selangor main river. Meanwhile, for the cadmium and iron, there are no safe limits set by all compared regulation. However, higher concentration of this metal will lead to many types of chromium and iron toxicity related disease. As conclusion, 65, 25, 11 and 24% of total cadmium, lead, copper and zinc respectively exceeded the safe limit by standard food regulation, and this situation will potentially expose the blood alcohol consumer to the harmful effect such as heavy metal related disease and other negative consequences. The consumption of alcohol not only giving a risk to the surrounding population but also to the entire Malaysian population due to their higher domestic demand and followed by a relatively limited supply of this species. It is believed that rapid industrialization and the uncontrollable discharge of effluent to the river without proper treatment was contributed to this problem. Therefore, present review is important to planning of regularly seafood and contaminant risk monitoring program. It is recommended to conduct proactive measures in controlling and managing waste emission and effluents as key source of contaminant to ensure that the health risk to consumers can be minimized. And that's all for my presentation today. Thank you so much for your time. Assalamualaikum.